And welcome to Mona's Magic Hour again. Today we're gonna have with us somebody very, very special, a very old friend, Gaurang Arora, who is, he wears many hats. He's a voice actor, he is a dubbing director, he runs his own dubbing company, and he is an absolute sound expert. Right. So the reason I've called him on today is because, you know, everybody is grappling with the same issue in the voice industry. And all of us are wondering, how do we get back to work? And we have so many doubts and fears about building our own home studio. And, you know, I've been trying to address some of those issues over the last few weeks through these live sessions. And I'd like to call Gaurang in now. I'd like to invite him in to talk about some of these issues.
Hi.
Hi, Gaurang. How are you?
Good, really good, really good.
Good. I hope both of us have got our technology right. These are two people who hardly use social media. I mean, you probably less than me.
I don't use at all.
Yeah.
So, I was really nervous about doing this, so Eliza really helped me.
Yeah. So a lot of our friends have joined, which is very, very nice. So Gaurang, you know, we had a little chat about this, and you know that you and I have been talking over the last couple of weeks also about the challenges that the voice industry is facing. So how have you been dealing with the COVID situation? Tell me.
Personally? Or as
personally and professionally, both.
Personally, I have had no difference in my life. In fact, it was slightly better than otherwise. I did not have to travel. I hate traveling in Bombay. I was at my beautiful house with a beautiful family and a beautiful dog, and it was perfect. I mean, as perfect as can be. And that's also I made sure that I did not sit idle because I had things to do. And because most of my staff was almost quarantined at home, I was the only working member of my team. Very recently, two more members have started working. So I was busy. I kept myself busy, I must say. And I invited people to keep me busy.
Good. That's awesome. So how did you keep yourself busy? Tell me.
First of all, my own work. And then figuring out ways wherein we can get these things started, experimenting. Seeing new technologies, talking to artists, experimenting with them, as in recording with them and using all the various methods possible, recording my own voice and checking, having Onima as the bait so many a times to experiment. The initial few days were very less work. Because people were not, clients were not confident that the work can be done until we could convince them. So it was all experimentation then. And the biggest guinea pig of my experiment, I would say, was Sahil.
Sahil has joined us.
Most experiments were done on him.
Yes.
Hi, Sahil.
Sahil Ved, who was with us last week, is also here today. Very nice to have you. So tell us, Gaurang, now, in terms of the challenges for voice actors that you're seeing mostly, because, you know, everybody wants to get back to work. Everybody's hungering to get back to work. But at the same time, there is the fear of the unknown out there. And secondly, you know, we don't know when another lockdown will be imposed.
Exactly.
We'll be stuck at home again. So
that is
everybody
lockdown
wants to know.
Could be just now, just around the corner.
Yeah, and you know, that's one aspect of it. But I think a lot of us, especially me, we've woken up to the fact that it's great to have a recording set up at home, you know. So to that effect, you know, if you can help us, give us some tips on an ideal booth size, maybe like a minimum, even considering Bombay homes, a minimum booth size so that, you know, you don't have too much of reflection or too much of it's booming too much, you know, the voice. And those kind of things. So what would you say is a minimum booth size?
Minimum booth size is very large. We can't afford it. So let's face the hard facts first. everything yeah. we are going to do or we are going to achieve or I'm going to suggest is going mm-hmm. to be a compromise. Because yeah. even when we build a studio, we aim to use the largest room for the best possible sound. I mean, yeah. you know, you have yeah. studios. We use yeah. the bigger the room, the better, because it takes sound is energy. It there should be enough distance for the energy to dissipate into the environment, into the walls, into right. the acoustics, into the diffusions. The smaller the room, of course, the worse the sound. But then काम चलाओ sound, the sound, I mean काम चलाओ का मतलब है कि काम चलाओ even for Netflix standards is possible mm-hmm. in a room as small as your bedroom. Bedroom can be कितना? The smallest bedroom you can imagine to be 10 feet by 8 feet. That is the smallest you can think of.
जो But हमारे जो इधर बॉम्बे में बहुत popular नहीं है half bedroom.
I know.
Three and half bedroom. Two and a half bedroom. Is good enough for a sound studio.
It is good enough. But important thing to note is our rooms are made of plastered walls, brick walls, and yeah. they are extremely reflective. And we yes. have corners as well. And the yes. biggest culprits are the corners. So. Oh. किसी भी अकूस्टिक के लिए यू नो अगर कोई आर्टिस्ट कभी पूछता है कि मैं ये पैनल लगा लूं अमेज़न पे ये टाइल मिल रही है 1.5 inch हाइट की फोम की दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क द नंबर वन स्टेप इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हैव बेस ट्रैक्स देयर इज नथिंग बेटर देन बेस ट्रैक्स व्हाई बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल द सैंपल्स दैट आई रिसीव फ्रॉम ऑल द आर्टिस्ट दैट वर ट्राइंग टू सेंड मी द ओनली प्रॉब्लम आई फेल्ट वॉज इन द लोअर एंड्स इन द बेस लेवल्स बेस लेवल्स हाई हैं और उनको कंट्रोल करने के लिए आपको बेस ट्रैप्स लगाने पड़ेंगे दीवारों पे फोम लगाकर हीट लॉन लगाकर यहाँ तक कि अकूस्टिक पैनल्स लगाकर भी यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू अचीव मच लोअर एंड रिडक्शन मतलब मच बेस रिडक्शन मच एको रिडक्शन जितना आप बेस ट्रैप्स से कर सकते हैं नाउ व्हाट आर बेस ट्रैप्स इज जस्ट कॉर्नर्स पे किसी तरह का बफरिंग वो एक मोटा सा गोल तकिया होता है professional bass traps ho sakte hain we have bass traps available on amazon but make sure that the rating is good before buying them there is a site called oral exchange it provides bass traps ceilings are very hard to control kyunki ceilings par kuch latkana kuch karna mushkil hota hai ab hamare beds ke corner mein deewaron ke corner mein wahan it is easier and also jitna aapke ghar mein cupboards honge wooden cupboards are better if you are recording yes. If possible, put the microphone inside the cupboard. Cover the cupboard के जो doors होते हैं, उन पर blanket लटका दीजिए और अपने पीछे उन doors को बंद कर दीजिए. Now, this all can work slightly. Now, फिर भी कुछ ना कुछ अच्छा करना पड़ेगा. You'll have to still cover the back of you. Now,
right.
ज्यादातर problems जो artist ये face करते हैं, उनको लगता है कि हमने mic को एक booth में बंद कर दिया. You know, एक वैसा भी आता है, एक ऐसा पूरा covered होता है, सेमी सर्कल जिसमें माइक बैठता है जिसको माइक्रोफोन शील्ड बोलते हैं द रिफ्लेक्शन शील्ड यू नो द फनी थिंग इज माइक्रोफोन इज हियर द शील्ड इज हियर लेकिन माइक्रोफोन का सेंसर सामने है सामने टू ब्लॉक द साउंड इट्स ओनली योर फेस रेस्ट एवरीथिंग इज खुला हाउ विल यू ब्लॉक
इन फैक्ट आई वाज वंडरिंग
पीछे कुछ रखना पड़ेगा
I was wondering, does it make sense to have two shields and keep one behind you?
Yes. But again, upar wala khali reh jayega. And also yes. the shields are smaller in size. There will be a lot more. And secondly, most of the shields that I see on Amazon or even on Alibaba, what do they have? What is the material inside? We have to understand that. Sirf bechne ke liye wo aluminium ki ek grill laga dete hain, uske upar foam laga dete hain. That is not enough. It is not going to work. So yeah. unless you have it in
it's
hand,
very very basic, it,
you can't know.
Yeah.
My suggestion has never been to invest in acoustics. Never. Right. I have always said ki aapke ghar pe jo hai, dekhte hain usse kya kya banta hai. Jo kuch bhi aapke ghar se use karo, do not waste money. Especially those acoustic foam panel waste of money jinko aap दीवारों पे लगाते हैं 2 feet by 2 feet of, और इतनी हाइट के होते हैं दैट इज फोम फोम कैन बेयरली एब्जॉर्ब द हायर फ्रीक्वेंसीज व्हिच आर नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम नॉट मच ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम दे आर अ प्रॉब्लम बट नॉट अ बिगर प्रॉब्लम द बिगर प्रॉब्लम इज द लोअर फ्रीक्वेंसी जो नीचे वाली फ्रीक्वेंसीज हैं उनमें प्रॉब्लम आती है और उन्हीं फ्रीक्वेंसीज पे रिवर्ब आता है तो बेस ट्रैप्स घर पे बेस ट्रैप्स अगर घर पे कुछ इंतजाम कर सके तो
बेस ट्रैप्स आर बेसिकली ब्लॉकिंग ऑफ कॉर्नर्स राइट
कॉर्नर्स
यू आर बेसिकली ब्लॉकिंग ऑफ अ कॉर्नर
यस यस आपको वो एड याद है मच्छरों वाली कि मैं कोने कोनों का 10,000 लूंगी सो थिंक ऑफ साउंड एज दोस कॉकरोचेस बिकॉज साउंड इज द रिवर्ब इज एम्पलीफाइड इन कॉर्नर्स टेक केयर ऑफ द कॉर्नर्स टेक लिटिल केयर ऑफ द वॉल्स बट द बेस्ट इज वर्क विद वॉट यू हैव डू नॉट गो ऑन इन्वेस्टिंग लेफ्ट राइट सेंटर वी हैव किट्स यू नो इनफैक्ट कुछ एक आर्टिस्ट को मैंने अकूस्टिक किट्स भेजी थी फ्रॉम ऑरल एक्सचेंज विच इज फॉर 40,000 रुपीज उसमें बेस ट्रैप्स भी है वॉल अकूस्टिक पैनल्स भी है बट आई डोंट नो हाउ इट वर्क्स यू नो समबडी हैज टू बाय एक्सपेरिमेंटेड कौन से साइज रूम के लिए कितना काम करता है व्हेन वी डिजाइन अ स्टूडियो द साइज ऑफ द रूम द डिमेंशंस व्हिच वॉल इज टॉलर देन द अदर एवरीथिंग आवर अकूस्टिक्स आर डिजाइंड अराउंड द शेप ऑफ द रूम And in most of the cases, we change the shape of the room. We make sure there are no parallel walls. We make sure there are no parallel ceilings to reduce parallel distortion, if someone can understand. So there's a whole lot deal that goes into making a studio. So ye mat sochi ki thoda bahut karne se hamara kaam chal jayega. And also, the suggestions that you will get online. Okay, if I search to now, right now, if I search that DIY home studio, 99.9% will not be for recording. They will be for mixing and auditioning. बहुत कम आपको मिलेंगे जो actually आपको ये बताएंगे कि dubbing के लिए कैसी sound चाहिए. Now for singing you need a live sound.
Yeah.
बहुत सारे studios में थोड़ा बहुत acoustic panel लगा के singing के लिए अच्छी sound बन सकती है. But you can't have a great sound for dubbing. When you are dubbing, you don't need any reflection because if it is an outdoor scene, you're on a mountain top. थोड़ा सा भी रिवर्ब आएगा तो आवाज नकली लगेगी दी ऑडियंस विल नॉट रियलाइज दैट रिवर्ब आया है बट इट विल नॉट अपियर एज इफ द आर्टिस्ट इज स्पीकिंग एनीवेज वी आर ब्रिजिंग गैप्स वी आर ब्रिजिंग द लिप सिंक गैप वी आर ब्रिजिंग द कल्चरल गैप उसके अंदर वी हैव टू ब्रिज दिस गैप ऑल्सो की जहां पर लगे कि स्क्रीन मतलब उस इंसान के मुंह से आवाज आ रही बस इतना तो लग जाए उसके लिए वी विल हैव टू मेक श्योर द अकूस्टिक्स आर गुड आवर एंड रिजल्ट हैज टू साउंड नेचुरल दैट इज द की ये नहीं कि कौन सा माइक्रोफोन बेटर है किसमें बॉडी ज्यादा आ रही है करने से साउंड अच्छी आएगी अच्छी इज नॉट व्हाट वी नीड इज अ नेचुरल साउंड कि वो आर्टिस्ट के मुंह से निकलती हुई लगे ये ना लगे कि स्क्रीन से या स्पीकर से आ रही है एंड देयर इज नो वन क्विक फिक्स सॉल्यूशन एवरी आर्टिस्ट विल हैव टू कम अप विद देयर ओन सॉल्यूशंस क्योंकि उनके घर पे क्या है ये हमें नहीं पता उनके घर पे क्या है ये उन्हीं को बताया दे विल हैव टू एक्सपेरिमेंट विद सेवरल थिंग्स रिकॉर्डिस्ट्स विल हैव टू हेल्प देम एंड रिकॉर्डिस्ट्स हैव बीन ऑल द हाउसेस इंक्लूडिंग योर हाउस मी वी हैव बीन हेल्पिंग रिकॉर्डिस्ट के नहीं अभी ठीक नहीं हुई अब ठीक हुई है बेटर है सो सिम्बायोसिस से काम चल रहा है एंड इसी तरह से चलेगा यू कांट एक सोल्यूशन नहीं बांध सकते कि बुलेट पॉइंट्स टक 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 इस तरह से नहीं चलेगा इट हैज टू बी वेरी ऑर्गेनिक वेरी वेरी ऑर्गेनिक
राइट So, yeah. between the ambition to just somehow put something together to get work started, yeah, the very basic. So, let's start with the very basic requirement to get work started. And then maybe we'll move to if somebody like me wants to build a real nice little home studio, then what would that entail? So, let's start with the very basic first.
Again, with regards to acoustics or with regards to recording and microphone and everything?
Both. You know, like how do we put the whole thing together? How do we start? Where do we go? So, how do we go about it?
So, when it comes to sound, let us give priorities to what is the best, what is the number one needed thing. So, the number one thing, good thing is not a microphone, it is the acoustics. अगर आपका अकूस्टिक्स करेक्ट है उसके बाद आपका माइक्रोफोन कैसा है दैट विल डिपेंड नंबर वन विल बी अकूस्टिक्स बिकॉज बहुत सारे लोगों को लगता है कि अच्छा माइक्रोफोन खरीदने से साउंड अच्छी हो जाएगी दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग नंबर वन इज अकूस्टिक्स बेसिक्स करने के लिए मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट जितना बहुत सारे लोग बेड पे बैठ के भी कर रहे हैं क्योंकि बेड पे नीचे पूरा कुशन मिल जाता है लेफ्ट और राइट में गद्दे खड़े कर देते हैं ऊपर कुछ कंबल सा लगा देते हैं एंड पहले क्या करते थे लोग, माइक को उस प्यारे से नेस्ट में, उस घोंसले में माइक को रख देते थे. बट आई टोल्ड देम कि माइक को मत रखिए, उस प्यारे से घोंसले में आप खुद रहिए, इट इज योर नेस्ट. बिकॉज माइक के सेंसर सामने है, माइक के सेंसर पीछे नहीं है. सो कवर मोस्ट ऑफ योर हेड, योर बैक, दैट विल बी अ बेटर थिंग. बिकॉज आपकी साउंड जब बाहर जाएगी तब तो रिफ्लेक्ट होके वापस आएगी. तो आप अपनी आवाज को ही बाहर मत जाने दीजिए. डोंट लेट दियर साउंड एस्केप टू योर वॉल्स, लेट इट गो डायरेक्टली. तो थोड़ा बहुत आएगा वापस से, उसको we will eliminate with methods like using a dynamic microphone or you know putting something behind the microphone. The first step is cover everything on the side and behind of you. This is a source of audio. Make sure that the audio does not reach to the walls, the sound does not reach to the walls. Sabse pehla step hai, aapki awaaz diwaron tak pahunche hi nahi. The first step.
So tell me if I'm not mistaken, then let's say I open my cupboard, okay, sit with my back to the cupboard where the clothes are behind me, okay, and put the microphone in front of me and put the reflection shield in front of it so that the back of the mic is also covered by the reflection
yes.
shield, which is pretty much the job of the mic. Yeah, so on the top, the cupboard doors can have the kambal or whatever
yes.
on top of
yes.
it, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
would that
yes.
be a doable option?
Yes, yes, that will be a doable thing. That will be a doable thing. And many people who can't, because lockdown to ab khula hai aur dobara khul sakta hai, so maybe you won't be able to order microphone sheets. So what you can do is aapke bed ka jo gadda hota hai aajkal, jo coir foams aate hai, they are very sturdy, they don't bend. So aap usko khada kar sakte hai, chahe wo aap apne piche khada kare ya aap cupboard ko apni back rakh ke mic ke piche us gadde ko khada kar de. So that will give you a very good sound. But also cover the top. So covering the top is also very important.
Right. So it may be actually really worthwhile to just invest in a few coir mattresses that can form a kind of a box.
If you want to invest in proper acoustic panels. If you want to invest, otherwise don't invest.
There you go.
I'm talking to all the artists. अगर आप invest करना चाहते हैं तो अच्छी चीज में acoustic panels में, glass wool या rock wool panels में invest कीजिए. लेकिन गद्दों में और इन सब चीजों में इन्वेस्ट मत कीजिए, जो आपके पास है उसी से काम चलेगा.
ओके, सो टेल अस हाउ डू वी सिलेक्ट दीज पैनल्स एंड वेयर डू वी फाइंड देम फ्रॉम एंड व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज वी शुड बी लुकिंग फॉर.
ओके, द प्रॉपर्टीज आई विल टेल यू द प्रॉपर्टीज दैट यू शुड नॉट बी लुकिंग फॉर. सबसे पहले तो आई टोल्ड यू बेस ट्रैप्स. सो व्हाट यू शुड सर्च फॉर इज यू शुड पुट अ माइनस बिफोर फोम. एनीथिंग टू डू विद फोम वी डोंट नीड. Anything right. to do with foam, we don't need unless there is a proper acoustic glass wool or rock wool panel behind it. Now there right. are other composite materials also which are better in sound absorption, and that will be a course for a different debate. Lekin anything with foam, don't buy. Number one, buy a bass trap. Number two, buy an acoustic panel jisme rock wool ya glass wool, or rock wool and glass wool, because for the amount of thickness they will provide you the maximum sound absorption.
Okay, so if not foam, then glass wool or rock wool. And should these be layered wool. Should are these usually layered panels or they are one
layering
just
layer,
one?
The more the layers, the expensive. I have never bought made panels in my life, so I will not be able to give you a purchase decision. I have always built them myself. But I know ke kya nahi kharidna hai. I know that foam does not work. I know that there are expensive foam panels, they do not work. Even if they do work, they will eliminate or reduce the higher frequencies, and which will only accentuate the lower frequencies. That will be a bad sound. That will be a worse sound than even before.
Right.
So just don't buy anything with foam. Look for acoustic panels. Acoustic panels have ratings written between me. Unke niche na ratings likhi hoti hai. Look for those ratings. The higher the rating, the absorption coefficient, the better. Now, I told you oral exchange is kind of a I found the only place in India which actually kind of deals with proper things, because it is one site which is dedicated only to these things. But I can't vouch for all of their products. I don't know if all their products work really well. But I saw that they do have something which looks closer to a sound panel.
Is A-U-R-A-L-E-X-C-H.
E-X-C-H-A-N-G-E, one sec.
oral exchange. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Okay. So we can look for panels from there.
So,
and you're saying it's important to cover the top and the sides and the back, but not so much the bottom?
अगर आप नीचे भी रखोगे ना तो प्रैक्टिकल नहीं होगा बिकॉज यू नीड टू इफ यू आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम द फोन यू नीड यू नो स्क्रिप्ट भी हाथ में होनी चाहिए यू कांट रियली डू मच अबाउट व्हाट इज बिलो द माइक्रोफोन एंड मच ऑफ इट इज टेकन केयर ऑफ बाय योर चेयर योर बॉडी एंड योर बेड
Right.
And, or your sofa for that matter. Yeah.
Good. Okay. So, and so there's no, of course, I mean, this will have to, people will have to take it on a case to case basis, depending on how noisy their room is or their background is and, to see how much paneling they need, right?
Let's take noise out of this discussion because we are not talking about noise. None of the acoustic panels are dealing with noise. Soundproofing and sound absorption or sound diffusion are completely different topics.
Hmm.
You, if you want to make your home soundproof, it is a different game. But that is not what we are looking for. Soundproof would mean ki bahar ki awaaz andar nahi aaye, bahar ki noise andar nahi aaye. These acoustic panels are going to do nothing for that. Bass traps will do nothing for that. Foam panels will do nothing for that. Acoustic panels will do nothing for that. उसके लिए आपको अपने सारे खिड़की दरवाजों को सील करना पड़ेगा विद सिलिकॉन एंड मोर लेयर्स बट दैट इज नॉट एडवाइजेबल बिकॉज वी आर लिविंग इन अ होम अनलेस यू रियली वांट टू यू नो यू हैव योर ओन रूम व्हिच यू वांट टू रियली कन्वर्ट इनटू अ स्टूडियो यू ओन द प्लेस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई मीन हाउ मेनी ऑफ अस ओन द प्लेसेस एंड यू हैव दैट यू नो 50 टू 100 स्क्वायर फीट ऑफ प्लेस व्हिच यू कैन डेडिकेट टू अ स्टूडियो It will be very few cases which will need this, and I'm sure aise koi cases honge, so they will employ a sound designer, a studio designer to do their job.
If they have to do a whole room, like really do a whole room.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Because sound absorption to ho jayegi baaton baaton mein, you know, testing karke. But soundproofing kaise hogi? Soundproofing ke liye you need a whole lot of things.
Yeah. Always Blissful is asking 1 inch or 2 inch thickness, which is enough to put on the walls, which panels are better.
Achha, who is asking? Okay.
Always Blissful.
If you are putting foam panels, even 3 inches is not enough. But acoustic panels, 2 inches minimum. 2 inches is minimum. 1 inch.
The thicker the better, basically.
But again, depends on your room. Experiment. Yeah. Depends on your microphone. Depends on a microphone greatly. If you have a unidirectional microphone, I mean, look at my room. My room doesn't even have bass traps. But I'm using a unidirectional microphone. Which means, sirf main jo yahan bolunga, sirf wahi record hoga, yahan ka record nahi hoga. So if you have a unidirectional microphone, a few of your walls are somehow, you know, you have bookshelves. One of your walls is completely open. You can keep it open or covered with curtains. I mean, each room has its own property. Microphone also plays a big role here.
Yeah, okay. So maybe we'll move to microphones then. First of all, selection of microphone, and secondly, placement of microphone.
Yeah. So number one point, highlighted, bold, underlined in red, do not buy condenser microphones. Do not buy condenser microphones.
I know, unless we're always tempted to buy those, but yeah.
Yeah. There are a couple of reasons why we buy. One of them is because they are the most readily available. They are easily available because it is easier to manufacture a condenser USB microphone than a normal condenser microphone. A normal condenser microphone needs phantom power, 48. The circuit has to be built in. But in a USB microphone, the electric supply is already there. So it's easier for them to manufacture a condenser. And there is no much cost difference between a condenser and a dynamic. So manufacturers mostly make condenser microphones because they will pay them more. And if you see the USB dynamic microphones, they cost almost the same as the condenser microphones.
Okay.
Condenser microphones are sensitive. Condenser microphones work by the electric signal that is supplied to them from your USB connections or from the phantom power, which means they are always on.
Right.
Even dynamic microphones are always on, but dynamic microphones work with the energy of sound. So if I'm speaking something, or if there is a sound from outside, that sound energy is converted into electric energy and that comes to your machine. Whereas condenser microphones are like open ears. They are capturing absolutely everything. Of course, depending on what is their captured direction or the pattern, which we call it. But condenser microphones will always capture a lot more noise, lot more reverb, and lot more...
From all around.
Not always all around. Not always all around. Depends on their pattern. Even condenser microphones have patterns. Like I said, this is a unidirectional microphone. Condenser microphones are not unidirectional, but there are cardioid patterns, which means they eliminate sound from the back, but not from the front. But they are still more sensitive than dynamic mic. And because they have, they don't rely on sound as an energy.
Anyways, so what about lavaliers or lapels?
Whether it is a phone, whether it is a lapel microphone, whether it is camera microphones, which means the video camera microphones, these are omnidirectional microphones. We have to understand how we talk on the phone. When we talk on the phone, the microphone is here. We are not talking like this, which means the microphone is designed to capture off-axis voice. The same is with the lapel. The lapel is attached here. It is designed to capture off-axis sound. If something is designed to capture off-axis sound and you use it at home, it will capture everything. And and they are extremely sensitive, especially a lapel microphone. They are so strong that even if you attach it at the lower collar or even near your belly, pet ke paas bhi usko lagao, tab bhi wo aapki awaaz capture karta hai. And lapel microphones, phone microphones, or some other sensitive microphones, aap jitna muh ke paas leke jaoge, wo utna distort microphone ke andar hi kar dega. There is no other level that you can use to correct, because the diaphragm itself, it's beyond its capacity to take those sounds, to take that many decibels. So lapel microphones, absolutely no. Some phones work, iPhone works well, but of course it is not as good as at eliminating background noises as dynamic microphone.
Right. So Sneha is asking, what does the sound quality differ between a dynamic and a condenser microphone?
All right.
The sound quality it captures.
All right. Yeah. Okay. There is not a simple answer to this, but I will take my time and explain it to you. A condenser microphone, because it is very sensitive and it is powered, it will capture the whole range of frequencies all the time. Okay, but a dynamic microphone, क्योंकि उसको power, energy और electricity मेरी आवाज से मिल रही है, तो जितनी आवाज में जो frequencies होगी, वो उन्हीं को electricity में electric signal में convert कर सकता है. So when it comes to the absolute higher frequencies or the absolute lows or a complete range of sound, a condenser microphone is definitely more to capture those. Having said that, we are using microphones for recording our voice. Most of our recording is for characters. When we talk, when I'm talking to a person, I'm a few feet away, and with corona, at least 6 feet away, but that's a different thing. But not speaking into the ear, you know, hum log uske kaan mein baat nahi karte, hum kisi ke kaan mein baat nahi karte. Now, jab kisi ke kaan mein baat karenge, they will realize that the slightly different. It is a different sound.
Right.
It is not this. It is same voice. But when we are talking in the 2 inches, 4 inches, 5 inches, it's a different sound. So when we mix, we are anyways cutting off all those frequencies that don't sound natural. Mixing engineers will always cut off those frequencies which will not sound natural. Aur agar wo character screen se dur hai, to hum low frequencies ko aur high frequencies ko aur zyada kaatte hain. That is how mixing is done. That is how perspective is given. Unless we have a character jiske lips are on the screen, you know, but even then, you know, these microphones are really good at capturing everything.
Okay.
If it is a voiceover, condenser microphones can be slightly better depending on how much money you're willing to spend. But if you compare a good dynamic microphone and a cheap condenser microphone, the cheap condenser microphone will give you a worse sound than a good dynamic microphone. I mean, it's with, about the money
the
you
At the same
quote.
Price range, at the same price range, what would you recommend? So,
if the acoustics are good?
Correct, exactly.
If the acoustics are good and perfect, condenser.
Yeah.
If the acoustics are perfect, condenser, but a good quality. But a good quality.
At the same price range as a Dynam.
At the same price range. Again, not at the same price range because Dynam microphones are usually cheaper.
Yes, yes.
So I can also go ahead and say that if you buy a dynamic microphone for say 8,000 and buy a condenser microphone for say 8,000, you might get a better sound. You might get a better sound with the dynamic.
Absolutely. Yeah. I was just coming to that. If you had to work within a budget, then you're much better off going with a dynamic microphone.
Yes.
Yeah, because then also, your acoustics also quality, you have to spend less, and the microphone also you have to spend less.
Yes, and मतलब ये एक धारणा है कि condenser microphones में body अच्छी आती है या और dynamic microphones में नहीं आती है. I remember I told you that there are three things. One is the acoustic, second is the microphone, third is the engineer. An engineer can take out a much, much better sound from a dynamic.
Yeah.
And an engineer can really screw up the kind of microphone sound. So everything is so subjective. It's so subjective. Engineers jo dynamic microphone se itni pyari awaaz nikal sakte hain ki and even if you give them condenser microphones, it's not that condenser microphone ki sound usse better hogi. In fact, even right now, a good engineer, a condenser microphone say $40,000 and a dynamic microphone say $8,000, he will make them sound exactly good, not one better than the other. So this distinction, these are, you know, I mean,
tell me, when you hear a recording,
condenser is better. Condenser is not better.
I've often wondered with the really experienced sound engineers like yourself, when you hear a recording, can you make out what it has been recorded on?
No. Unless it's very pathetically mixed, I can't. If it is mixed well,
So where it has been recorded, recorded on, you can't make out.
I can't, but maybe I'm not that good at it. There may be other people who are good at it. I can't.
Raghav is asking us, if I have a dynamic microphone, do I need to have acoustic panels? I have walls behind, ahead, and on the sides of my mic.
Oh, one second. Let me scroll back to that question. Was it very far ago?
Raghav is asking, if I have a dynamic microphone, do I need to use acoustic panels? I have walls behind, ahead, and on the side of my mic.
If you have walls all around, you will need something. If not acoustic panels, you will need something. Yes. You will need either a bookshelf, a cupboard, jis mein bahut sare kapde rakhe hon, and you keep the cupboard open. If all the four walls are brick walls, then even dynamic microphone will fail. You will need acoustics
Does it help to have curtains at the back?
A bit, but not much. Thicker the curtains, the better. More the folds, the better. Thicker the curtains, the better. It will help, but to an extent. Again, these things will eliminate the higher frequencies sound. A higher frequencies reflection, but lower frequencies are very nasty. No, it is the most difficult to eliminate are the lower frequencies. जब भी लोग सैंपल्स भेजते हैं वो कहते हैं कि मैंने तो अपने आप को कंबल में बंद किया था, सब कुछ बंद किया था, फिर भी आवाज आ रही है. लो फ्रीक्वेंसीज विल क्रॉस थ्रू ऑल बैरियर्स. दे डोंट लिसन. आई मीन दोस फ्रीक्वेंसीज आर ह्यूज. आई मीन मोर देन 1 मीटर इन डायमीटर. आई मीन द वेव ऑफ देम. सो दे कैन क्रॉस ऑल मोस्ट बैरियर्स. द बेस्ट थिंग टू डू इज टू नॉट लेट योर साउंड रीच द वॉल्स.
राइट, ऑफ कोर्स.
ओके, लेट मी गिव दिस लिटिल टेक्निकल इन्फॉर्मेशन. जब आवाज आपके मुंह से निकलती है ना, तो उस वेव का साइज थोड़ा छोटा होता है, लेकिन जब वो दीवार से टकरा कर वापिस आती है तो उस वेव का साइज बड़ा हो जाता है. तो इसके लिए अगर आप ये सोचें कि दीवार से वापिस आने वाली साउंड को मैं रोकूंगा, तो आपको और बड़े अकूस्टिक पैनल की जरूरत पड़ेगी. इसलिए आपकी आवाज दीवार तक ना पहुंचे, इसी में बेटर, यही बेहतर है, क्योंकि वो वेव छोटी की छोटी रहेगी और आप उसे छोटे बैरियर से कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं. लेकिन आप जितना अपने आवाज को एस्केप होने देंगे, उतने आपको बड़े बैरियर्स लगेंगे. उतने आपको दीवार पे ज्यादा अकुस्टिक मटेरियल लगाना पड़ेगा.
बट इफ यू आर सिटिंग इन द सेंटर ऑफ लेट्स से अ हॉल, अ लिविंग रूम, यू नो, जस्ट टू स्टे फर्दर अवे फ्रॉम वॉल्स, देन यू नो आई फाइंड दिस अ प्रॉब्लम दैट यू नो यू आर गोइंग टू रन इनटू वन और द अदर प्रॉब्लम.
The thing is, one more thing that artists can do is they can look for a sweet spot. You know, हमारे studios में भी, हमारे acoustically designed studios में भी, there is just one or two sweet spots. Sweet spots का मतलब ये होता है कि हर जगह पर उतनी ही आवाज नहीं गूंजती है, कि किसी जगह पर कम गूंजेगी, किसी जगह पर ज्यादा गूंजेगी. Now I am not talking about rooms where it is all 100% walls all together. हर कमरे में कुछ ना कुछ रहता है, कभी कुछ कभी कम से कम सोफा या बेड तो रहेगा, या कुर्सियां रहेंगी, एक अलमारी, खिड़की, कुछ ना कुछ रहेगा किसी ना किसी कमरे में. अगर ऐसा, अगर प्लीज लुक फॉर अ स्वीट स्पॉट. इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू कीप अ कबर्ड बिहाइंड यू और यू आर एबल टू सिट इनसाइड अ कबर्ड, द बेस्ट इज टू सिट इनसाइड द कबर्ड और यूज द कबर्ड टू इट्स मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी. लेकिन अगर आप ऐसा नहीं करना चाहते, अगर आप ओपन कमरे में रिकॉर्ड करना चाहते हैं, देन लुक फॉर अ स्वीट स्पॉट. बट इन होम रिकॉर्डिंग,
नॉट इन द सेंटर ऑफ अ रूम.
No, it can't. I can't say it. The center of this room can be a sweet spot, but it will depend entirely from room to room. It can't be a simple answer for that.
Right.
In an untreated room, center of the room, no way. Corner of the room, no way. If it is treated, maybe. Even depending on the acoustics, the bass traps, and the other things around.
Okay. Always Blissful is asking: is it preferable to place a microphone in a box surrounded from inside with acoustic panels? Does this further help in better sound if you are already sitting in a room with acoustic panels around?
Okay. We have done experiments with this. Some of our artists have also tried to put this microphone in a box thing. It is a bad idea because it will make it sound bahut hi boxy sound ho jati
hai. That
box is not able to absorb all the sound. We are speaking into the microphone. वो हमारी आवाज माइक्रोफोन को क्रॉस करके पीछे जाती है, वहां से बॉक्स के पीछे अंदर जाती है, वहां से बाउंस होके वापस से उसके साइड्स में आके इट क्रिएट्स अ वेरी डर्टी मडी साउंड. बॉक्स इज अ बिग क्रॉस. नो बॉक्सेस. इवन इफ यू हैव अकुस्टिकली ट्रीटेड रूम, नो बॉक्सेस. एक बार के लिए अ गुड क्वालिटी माइक्रोफोन शील्ड स्टिल आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड, बट बॉक्स नो.
एंड साहिल एंड
आई नो देयर इज अ प्रोडक्ट, I know there is a boxy product, but that is slightly bigger, but I haven't tested it. I can't vouch for it. There is a product which is very expensive. I think it is for 60,000-70,000. Something. Oxy something. They must have lined it with the proper acoustic materials and all. I'm not too sure because that distance is not enough for sound to die. The energy of the waves is too strong ki itne se distance mein wo acoustic materials ko kha kar maar sake. It could be a quick fix solution, but I'm not sure it is going to work. I'll have to test it out. There are products available. There are expensive products also available. Yeah, some more questions here.
Sahil and Soumya are saying that they are amazed how good an SM58 is in this situation. A simple SM58, a Shure microphone.
Okay.
So do you want to give us some tips?
Okay, on the kind of dynamic microphones, that is?
Yeah, what's a good reasonable? What are the reasonably good mics to invest in? Dynamic microphones, like the Shure SM58.
For home studios,
for home studios.
Again, there cannot be a straight answer to this. For home studios who do not have have great acoustics, should go for unidirectional dynamic mics. Unidirectional, not unidirectional condenser mics like the shotgun mics that is used in shootings. Unidirectional dynamic mics. There are a few available. Unidirectional would mean that they're only this part is sensitive, the rest are not sensitive or less sensitive. So look for unidirectional dynamic microphones. SM58 is of course a very great microphone for live performances as well, and also for studio. It has been used and tested everywhere. But it does not mean that it is the only good microphone. But it can be, you know, aankh band karke suggest kiya ja sakta hai. That's where it sits. But you can have... I'll tell you why I invest in cheaper microphones. This is a 2300 ka microphone. I invest in cheaper stuff and I also buy sometimes very cheap phones. Although I'm talking on an iPhone, I buy very, very cheap things so that I can suggest people that this works. So yeah. This is a 1300 Audio Technica. This is for 2500 from Amazon. And wow. If you buy from Shalu Music, it is 4000. But I don't know why he sells this expensive. Other things are cheaper with him.
Yeah,
but this is expensive. So I buy cheap things so that I can test them out and I can suggest people ki nahi itne mein bhi acha milta hai. So this is a 1300 Audio Technica, which is a cheap microphone, but it gives a good quality sound. I have expensive Dynamics also with not very expensive. There is a Sennheiser D5, there is a Shure SM58, but this gives a really good sound. And it eliminates reverb better than SM58 because it is unidirectional. SM58 is not. So when I have a room like this, this is giving me a better quality than SM58. So when you ask me, is SM58 the best quality mic? I'll say it depends on your acoustic. There is no one simple plain answer to this. But if you have compromised acoustics, unidirectional mic is the way to go.
When you say it depends on the acoustics and your voice, what exactly do you mean? On what basis should we decide?
The more reflection your room creates, the less you need a unidirectional mic. So SM58, okay. Of course, it might. I don't know whether SM58 can create a better sound than this because I'll have to record and then mix it onto it. But the more wide ranging microphones you can buy. Now, if you buy microphones online or if you look for microphones, you will see that they have these frequency ranges, 60 hertz to 15 kilohertz, the frequencies. That is the range of the microphone, how much it can capture. If your acoustics are not as good, don't go for a higher ranging microphone. Look for microphones which have a lower range. But ekdam hi kachra range na ho, look for good companies. And test it. Look for reviews. Ask people around. Okay, but if you're confident with your acoustics, how will you be confident? You can test your sound with certain engineer, or you can send it to studios and tell them ki bhaiya dekho kaise sound hai. If your acoustics are good, then you can go with microphones jinki range zyada hai. Dynamic microphones mein bhi zyada range wale microphones aate hain. But having said that, zyada range does not mean better sound. Again, it does not mean better sound. If the sound was meant to be for a character, तो उसको बहुत बेटर होने की जरूरत नहीं है. लुक, लिसन टू अमेरिकन वॉइसेस, दे आर सो थिन. क्या उनकी वॉइस में बॉडी होती है? हाँ, हम लाउड करके सुनेंगे तो होती है थोड़ी बहुत, बिकॉज वो लैंग्वेज में भी थोड़ी बहुत, बिकॉज ऑफ द प्लोसिव्स इट साउंड्स अ लिटिल हेवियर देन हिंदी, बट दैट्स अ लैंग्वेज थिंग. बट अदरवाइज वी डोंट नीड अ, मतलब हमें बॉडी नहीं चाहिए. आई डोंट नो वेयर डिड दिस ऑब्सेशन फॉर बॉडी कम, पता नहीं कहाँ से आया है. ये शायद 50-60 से चलता आ रहा है कि साउंड में बॉडी होनी चाहिए. सो एवरी इंजीनियर जो मतलब पढ़ के नहीं आया है, जो स्टूडियोज में सीखा है, समवन लाइक मी, बॉडी, साउंड में बॉडी नहीं है. अरे बकवास माइक्रोफोन, साउंड में बॉडी नहीं है. अरे क्यों चाहिए बॉडी? मेक इट साउंड नेचुरल. हम किसके लिए रिकॉर्ड करें? ऑडियंस के लिए. ऑडियंस को पता भी नहीं चलना चाहिए कि रिकॉर्डिंग अच्छी है बुरी है. ऑडियंस का दिमाग रिकॉर्डिंग पे क्यों जाए? ऑडियंस का दिमाग डायलॉग पे, स्टोरी पे, मतलब प्लॉट पे जाना चाहिए. ऑडियंस, आवर वॉइस शुड बी, आवर साउंड क्वालिटी शुड बी इनविजिबल टू देम. इट हैज टू बी इनविजिबल. आवर मिक्सिंग हैज टू बी इनविजिबल. इट हैज टू साउंड लाइक दैट पर्सन इज स्पीकिंग इन दैट सिनेरियो विद दोस साउंड इफेक्ट्स. मतलब अगर वो खेत में है तो खेत की आवाज के साथ में उसकी आवाज मर्ज हो, इस तरह की साउंड होनी चाहिए. उसके लिए आपको बॉडी नहीं चाहिए. सो अगेन, देयर इज नो आंसर टू व्हिच माइक्रोफोन इज बेटर. SM58 is an excellent microphone. उसकी अच्छी बात ये है कि it has a very nice, मतलब अगर उसको हाथ में पकड़ा जाए या थोड़ा हिलाया डुलाया भी जाए, थोड़ा टच भी किया जाए, तो भी वो उतना रेजोनेंट साउंड उसमें लीक नहीं होती है. सिबिलेंस, स स की आवाज वो बहुत अच्छा पकड़ता है. और अगर कोई माइक्रोफोन स की आवाज मतलब कम पकड़े, दैट इज गुड. एंड SM58 does that, then we can, mixing में we can accentuate the high frequencies more and make it sound more brighter if we want to for a song or for a voiceover. Because otherwise वो sibilance बहुत irritate करती है, सर 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 जब आता है तो. So SM58 की वो एक खास बात है, but that doesn't make it better than other microphones. Again, किसी की आवाज SM58 से अच्छी आ सकती है, किसी की आवाज Neumann U87 में ही अच्छी आ सकती है. It is so subjective. There is no one answer. the sound recorders, if you speak to them around the world, they will tell you that they use different microphones for different artists. They will test for singing at least. Dubbing ke liye to you can hardly get to speak to people. Dubbing is such a ignored field internationally. You hardly get to speak to engineers who tell you about dubbing. डिज्नी वाले आते हैं कभी कभी 6-7 साल में एक बार बहुत अच्छा ज्ञान देके जाते हैं और वो 20-25 साल तक रहता है. द लास्ट टाइम दे हैड कम वाज फॉर योर कंपनी एंड द थिंग्स दे टोल्ड मी, आई मीन दैट हैज रियली शेप्ड हाउ आई थिंक अबाउट साउंड इवन टुडे. सो आई मीन आई थिंक आई डोंट थिंक एनी अदर कंपनी डज दिस टू ट्रेन पीपल दैट कैन लास्ट देम फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम.
राइट. शिल्पा इज आस्किंग व्हाट शुड वी डू टू रिकॉर्ड और डब फ्रॉम होम on an Android phone.
Don't do it.
Right, simple answer. Just don't do it.
but I can be elongated. I have only come across 2 or 3 devices which can record well. OnePlus recorded well. A few Samsung models did. But again, it cannot. It has to be taken with a pinch of salt because, like I said, those microphones are supposed to capture off-axis sound. They are not supposed to capture direct sound. So, if they are capturing off-axis sound, they will capture more reverb and more noise. Emergency में corrections भी आप भेजते हैं तब भी बताएं हम बहुत उस पे EQ करने के बाद उन corrections को match करते हैं. तो अगर आपको ये लगता होगा कि Android से मैंने कई बार sound भेजा और approve हो गया, वो client की मजबूरी है ये समझिए. It is not good sound.
And बहुत लोग Android कहते हैं कि नहीं मैं तो माइक पे मैं तो फोन पे ही रिकॉर्ड करती हूँ. राइट. सो मेनी पीपल टेल अस ना दैट वी रिकॉर्ड.
इट इज अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज. द क्लाइंट इज कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग बिकॉज इसके पास टाइम नहीं है. And Android is an operating system. अगर आपको brands पूछने पड़ेंगे, to my experience, Samsung and OnePlus to some extent have given me a little bit of acceptable quality after a lot of EQing to make it sit with a good dynamic or condenser microphone sound. But otherwise, not an excellent option.
Okay. Haan,
there is one option. Yeah. There is one option. There are USB microphones available, which can connect to your Android phone. If you use those USB dynamic microphones to connect to your Android phones and record, nothing like it.
Right. Yeah, I tried out a Samsung Q2 recently after you suggested it. Yeah, Q2U. And it worked well. And it worked better than my Apogee Hype and my Rode NT Mini and my Yeti Blue. I mean, I had to put aside everything that I've got and say, yeah, Samsung.
But the bad news is it is out of stock in India.
Oh,
no stockist has it. It is out of stock. Last I spoke to, 65 pieces were sold during lockdown of Samsung Q2Us and a couple of dozen of ATR 2005, which is an equally good microphone. ATR 2005 is a dynamic USB microphone. Now, these were the only two models available in India during lockdown. And apart from these two, there are only two other models in the world that have acceptable quality. That is the rarity of USB dynamic microphones. But that is
the beauty of them. And which are those two models?
ATR 2100 USB and Samsung Q1U, which is the older version of Q2U, which is still in stock. Q1U is still in stock.
Oh, wow.
And it has acceptable sound quality. But I'm assuming it bahut zyada dino tak stock mein nahi rahega.
Binaipur is asking, I primarily record voiceovers. She is recording on a Rode NT USB mic. Would it be a good idea to suggest to a studio that I'm happy to come to their studio to record, but record on my mic? Now, that may be a little difficult, Binaipur. How will you connect a USB mic to a studio? Gaurang, what are your thoughts on this?
You will need a fairly large USB cable. fairly long USB cable. And even then, it is quite likely that the power might not reach the microphone. In that case, you will need a powered USB hub to do so. But again, their patchings are already done. Most of the patchings are sealed. There is no conduit always openly available that you can pass a USB cable through. There are a couple more things, Mona, that I would like to tell about. One is about recording from home and shouting.
Yeah.
Okay, now Lalit ji, Lalit Agarwal, he has had experience, and where, you know, and many people have had experience that whenever you shout, reverb zyada sunai deta hai.
Naturally, yes.
Yeah, because again, you know why? Because shouting is a high pitched sound, so the low frequencies are all exposed. And also the high pitch sound has a lot more energy, it bounces the walls,
so
he gave a great suggestion that jabhi bhi chillana hota hai na, wo bed pe sidewise late jate hain aur microphone ko bhi apne saath chala dete hain. Can you imagine? such a crazy solution, and you won't believe he has done this for your house, and your engineers don't even know about it.
Oh, how cool!
That's a super crazy, ingenious solution.
Cool. But you know what? I want to quickly address one very important point that Vinayakar has brought up, is that artists are afraid to go to studios and speak into a microphone, thinking that, you know, that whole, the pop filter and the microphone may be contaminated. That's why she brought up the option of carrying her own microphone. Thinking that, you know, maybe the combination of the soundproofing of a studio.
If you want my opinion, I'll be very clear. Of course, in our group wherein we are, all our vendors are together, I have not been very vocal. But decontaminating a mic is not going to make any difference at all, because the aerosol particles are in the air. They are going to survive. There is no wind. There is no sun. I don't know how long it will survive. You know, in an AC room, the aerosol particles will get stuck into the AC filter. They will happily be there, because there is some moisture also, remember. They will very happy live there for I don't know how many days. I am not comfortable at, you know, artists coming in and out of the studio. I have started recording, but one artist comes for 3 days, then the studio is closed for 2 days, so that the virus can die on its own. But using a fumigation machine or a defogger to defog the studio and thinking that everything is fine, I can't do that, because I know that chemical is going to harm my machine. So I will not defog it. The virus will remain alive inside. It will die its own natural death.
Yeah, but what we are doing also is we are using UV light sanitize.
About UV light, UV light is effective, but you need a whole lot of it. I'm not sure if you know, we can have that much light into the studio to kill it. You can kill viruses with UV light, I think, on a phone or a setup or on microphones in a box. But what do you do about the rest of the things? What do you do about the chair, about the walls, about the microphone stand? I mean, I don't know how big a UV light you got, but I'm not comfortable yet opening up the studios. And also because I know that another lockdown is around the corner. अगर हमने आर्टिस्ट को अभी एम्पावर नहीं किया तो तब हम फिर फंसेंगे. अभी हमें लग रहा है कि खुल गया है, चलो वी आर कमिटिंग टू आवर क्लाइंट्स कि हाँ हम डिलीवर कर देंगे, सब कर देंगे, लेकिन जैसे ही लॉकडाउन होगा अगेन आवर कमिटमेंट विल बी, यू नो, अफेक्टेड. सो आई डोंट वांट टू गिव दैट. लास्ट थिंग, फीमेल आर्टिस्ट शुड बी वेरी 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 ऑफ बाइंग कंडेंसर माइक्रोफोन्स अगेन, बिकॉज देयर साउंड इज एट अ डिफरेंट हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी वेवलेंथ, तो उनमें लो फ्रीक्वेंसी की आवाज बहुत ज्यादा आ रही है. फीमेल आर्टिस्ट, प्लीज 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 कंडेंसर माइक्रोफोन्स कतई ना खरीदे, इवन इफ यूर are good, unless you are in a studio.
Maine already khareed ke jhel liya, even though I didn't have good acoustics. So anyway, Sahil baar baar iso box kya bol raha hai, ye iso box kya hai?
Iso box wahi hai jo maine aapko bola na, chota sa box hai jiska naam mujhe yaad nahi aa raha tha. That's a small box. I haven't tested it. It's an expensive thing. I mean, I can't tell you to buy it. Kitna 70-80,000 ka hai, kitna hai iska?
Okay.
I'm not comfortable with it. I'm not comfortable with using it because I have not tested and it is very expensive. मैं लोगों का मतलब पैसा खर्च नहीं करवा सकता. I can't suggest something कि वो पैसा खर्च दे और बचता है कि अरे गौरांग ने सजेस्ट किया था. I am not suggesting you to buy anything. I am telling you, whatever you have in your home, experiment with it and come up with the best solution. Let it be a to and fro with your recording engineer or for people who understand sound, but don't spend a whole lot of money on acoustics.
Basic problem that all of us face, the internet connection.
Right.
Yeah. So what kind of, have you got a sense of what kind of is the minimum connection speed that we ought to have for recording at home successfully if we want to record online, and also for sending information back and forth?
Right. So either we record online entirely, which means the video also comes to us online, and we whatever we record travels online via internet and can gets recorded in the studio or wherever the recordist is. For that, you need at least 20 yeah. megabits per second, 20 Mbps per second. But a big problem with that is mm-hmm. the first, our 4G connections are not going to give you that. You will have to have a dedicated cable internet at your home, wired internet. Only then it is possible. Otherwise, it is not possible because these connections are so bad. I think we are still in our 2G age. Just the name has changed to 4G. We are still in 2G age. And also with the wired internet, with cable internet, the bigger problem is some ISPs just do not give beyond 10 Mbps. Hathaway is criminal right. in restricting right. the users to a 10 Mbps upload speed. Upload speed is the main thing.
Yeah.
Download, बहुत कम हमें करना है. एक low quality video download करना है जो सुपरवाइजर या रिकॉर्डिस्ट बोल रहा है उसकी आवाजें हमको सुननी है. दैट डज नॉट नीड मच बैंडविड्थ बट वी डोंट हैव अपलोड स्पीड्स विद हैथवे स्पेसिफिकली एंड इवन विद सम इंटरनेट कनेक्शंस पीपल थिंक दैट यू नो आई हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रांग इंटरनेट कनेक्शन मेरे फिर क्यों नहीं हो रहा है. इट इज बिकॉज योर अपलोड स्पीड्स आर लो. इवन इफ योर अपलोड स्पीड्स आर लो यू नो जब भी घर पे केबल इंटरनेट लगता है तो एक टेंडेंसी होता है कि घर का हर मेंबर अपने फोन को वाईफाई से कनेक्टेड रखता है एंड विद व्हाट्सएप एंड इंस्टा एंड ऑल दीज फेसबुक अपडेट्स यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ द बैंडविड्थ इज कंज्यूम्ड बाय दीज एप्स ऑन फोन्स ऑफ योर अदर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड योर ओन फोन इज वेल. तो जब आप रिकॉर्डिंग करने बैठते हैं तो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट एवरीवन एल्स इज डिसकनेक्टेड अदरवाइज यू विल फेस ड्रॉपआउट इश्यूज. But of course, dropouts फिर भी आएंगे ही. The nature of internet is such because internet is not a straight line that is connected between the recordist and the artist. Internet is, you know, it's called internet because there is a net. It travels through so many different pathways, so many different servers, and तब जाके वो data packet कहीं पहुंचता है. So it is bound to have dropouts. वो आएंगे ही. उसके लिए आपको रीटेक लेना पड़ेगा. और देयर इज अनदर वे व्हिच आई कैन डिस्कस लेटर लाइक इफ यू वांट
डू इट नाउ.
देयर इज अ वे आउट ऑफ दिस. ओके अब तक एटलीस्ट योर हाउस व्हाट वाज डूइंग क्या कर रहा था वो. इट वाज यूजिंग सेशन लिंक प्रो जिससे वीडियो आपके आर्टिस्ट तक जाता है. आपकी आवाज जाती है, सुपरवाइजर की आवाज जाती है और आर्टिस्ट की आवाज भी गुड क्वालिटी में आपके सेटअप तक पहुंचती है. आई हैव अ सॉल्यूशन फॉर पुअर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन बिकॉज अपलोड स्पीड्स आर पुअर. While you are recording this session, let the artist also record in their laptop. Everything that is being said. ये नहीं कि artist को हर take stop करना पड़े. वो अपना एक audacity चालू करके recording चालू कर दे. Let everything get recorded in audacity. Let the artist not give a retake for glitches and you know technical internet dropouts if their internet speed is not good. At the end of the session, once your recordist is satisfied ki bhaiya sync theek hai, your supervisor is satisfied ki bhaiya delivery theek hai, to let the artist send that entire single wave file via WeTransfer or some other service to you, and then artist recordist ko baithkar ek baar sync karna padega, but it will resolve this internet issue once and for all, and also the quality will be better.
Right. Now, of course, I mean, people who are buying laptops and they're buying microphones are, of course, investing in audio software, also recording software also. But the way we record is we try to minimize the effort on the part of the voice actor so that they can concentrate on their performance and not have to do anything else. Because, you know, it already gets pretty hot in the home where you can't put the AC on. You can't put the fan on. You're dealing with headphones. You're dealing with noise, sweat, blow, this, that. So many things already. And at the same time, if we ask you to do more in terms of recording, etc., it could really... A lot of artists do get very impatient and get thrown completely. You know, they get fed up of the session. So we're trying to minimize that. But this is definitely a good idea for those who are able to do it. And we've never insisted on having any recording software. We've just said all you need is a laptop and a microphone and an internet connection. But
Yes, I buy your point totally that on the spot recording will reduce the internet related problems at least
substantially. And also the retakes will reduce. Once the retakes reduce, then the artist will get less frustrated, you know. And he will have to or she will have to stay lesser in a non-AC, non-fan environment.
Yeah, so moving on from internet, I think this is a very good thing that first of all, most important is to have a wired connection, not a wireless or a Wi-Fi connection, and not a shared connection, definitely something that goes directly into your machine.
Also,
most important, yeah?
But also, modern laptops do not have an Ethernet port. Modern laptops do not have an Ethernet port. So
you can get connectors, right? Can't you?
Yeah, we can get connectors. They're very expensive, but we can get. But if you have a modern laptop, chances are the laptop has gigabit Wi-Fi. Gigabit Wi-Fi is a very fast version of Wi-Fi. If you have one of those laptops and you have a gigabit internet like Airtel, you can use Wi-Fi as well. It's not necessary that sirf cable se hi achhi quality aayegi. In fact, if you are ready to record simultaneously in Audacity, you can do with Wi-Fi as well. You don't need a wired connection. And if you are ready to record in a lower data rate, for example, Source Connect, Now, Session Link Pro, they all allow you to record somewhere between 96 kilobits per second to 256 to 320 kilobits per second. If you use a lower data rate, that should also solve this direct internet problem. If a laptop does not have a port or if the cable wire can't reach to your place, and the reduction is in bit rates is not doing much in the audio quality for voice, at least that I have tested. I have used spectral analyzers and other ways of measuring whether there is a bit rate, whether there is a quality drop, whether there is a sample bit size drop, but there wasn't a discernible difference was zero. There is no difference after the mix is done and after everything, there is no difference whatsoever. So it's safe to go a lower bit rate. That can solve some problems.
Great. So we've gone through the bit rate. Now, what are the noise issues that we face with the laptops that we get?
Yes. Now, most laptops which are not very expensive have very noisy fans. Also, many people use desktop computers. Now, they use desktop computers and use a desktop mic stand, which is just kept on the desktop and the stand is itna sa, just a small height. Now, the PC noise, the CPU noise transfers to the desk, from the desk to the stand and from the stand to the microphone. That is a big issue. Laptop noise is a big issue.
Right.
Also, some artists are facing that whenever they kept their laptop on charging, there is an electric hum which also gets transmitted in the signal. That also adds to the noise. Of course, baki jo environmental noise hai, wo to hai, jo khidki ke bahar se aayegi, ya, jo aapke gharo se aayegi while the work in kitchen is going on, that we will have to eliminate by, closing our doors and windows very tightly. But of course, I always insist on unidirectional microphones, dynamic microphones. If you have a unidirectional dynamic microphones, you can even record with windows open. I record with window open. I have one of my walls is only windows. I keep those windows open so that the reflection is minimum. Yes, I keep those windows open while recording so the reflection is minimum. And also I stay in a quieter area. I don't have traffic around me. I stay in almost a jungle. There are birds, but at certain time of the day.
You want to make us jealous by telling us that you live in the midst of beauty while we live in a concrete jungle.
That's a decision everyone can make.
of course.
Right.
It's our choice. We are here by choice.
Yeah, Aksha Bilonia is saying, sometimes a view artist has to whisper and suddenly scream according to the script. How can I set a proper gain in such condition? How can I avoid clipping? So, Mona, do you want to look at these questions as they arrive or should we come to them later?
We can go, as they arrive.
Because the issue with Instagram I saw was,
we lose them otherwise.
We lose the questions, All right.
Yeah,
so, Okay, there are two ways to go about this. I would suggest you not to touch the gain a whole lot if possible. What I do is, or what I make Onima do is, we hang out of the window and record shouting scenes. Wherever we have to shout and wherever the pitch is louder, hum khidki ke bahar chale jaate hain.
What floor are you on?
It's the 18th floor.
My God.
But still, even if you are on a lower floor, I think reverb is a bigger enemy of sound than noises. If you take care of noise from all the other sources, it can be cleaned. And I do not know about Netflix, but all my work that I'm doing, we can clean the audio in a very, it can, gate nahi lagana hai, noise gate nahi lagana hai. I mean, it's technical, but it can be cleaned to an extent. But reverb is something that we cannot get rid of. So if there is a choice between reverb and noise, I will choose noise. So agar chillane wale scenes
right,
hai,
another just, very
also when you're shouting, you know, when you're whispering, if this is the noise, this is the whisper level, okay? But when you're shouting, you have to shout, matlab aapka level yahan chala jata, so that noise floor automatically goes down below. Because your range is, when your loudest part is this high, the noise automatically goes below. Na? So it is not much of a problem if you have to shout. Go out of the window, that's a good way.
Right.
And also, Akshay, there is one method which I had told last time, which Lalit Agarwal had used. He had, matlab wo so gaye the bed pe microphone leke, uske beech mein takiya rakh diya tha, and he shouted.
That is super innovative.
Yeah. I am not suggesting you to chhedo the gain a lot because we can't go away from the microphone. That is one thing. We can't go away from the microphone because there will be reverb. Hmm. But if you shout into the microphone, even with reduced gain, the diaphragm will distort. It will not be a pleasant sound. Hmm. You have to be a little away from the microphone if you have to shout. Otherwise, it will not be a good sound. So my idea is to either dampen the sound as much as possible with all the things that you have, all the acoustics that you can build up with home materials, or go out of the window. Terrace mein chale jaiye, kahin bhi chale jaiye shouting scenes karne ke liye, but it will work. Trust me, going outdoors will work for shouting scenes. Right.
That's if you're on the 18th floor.
But terrace mein ja sakte ho na?
Terrace pe ja sakte hain. Achha, there's someone asking, are XLR mics better than USB mics?
Okay, let's dwell into this topic. What is a USB mic is basically a microphone which has an inbuilt, jisko aap sound card bolte ho, which has an inbuilt audio interface, and it is connected via USB. And what is an XLR microphone? It's a microphone, you connect it to an audio interface and you connect it to your computer via USB or Firewire or Thunderbolt, whatever it is. Now, a microphone is an analog device, your computer is a digital device. It will have to convert the signal from analog to digital so that it can be recorded. It is these analog to digital converters which decide how good or bad the sound quality will be. If it is a good quality interface, it will give a very good quality sound. If the USB microphone has a very shabby analog to digital converter, it will give a very poor quality sound. So that depends on how much you're willing to spend. I am always suggesting USB dynamic microphones. All those USB dynamic microphones that I have tested, Samsung Q2U, ATR2005 USB, they have good analog to digital or AD converters built inside them. Which means inke andar jo sound card hai, wo bahut achhi quality ka sound card hai. और अगर आप उन्हें XLR से कनेक्ट करके किसी इंटरफेस पे लगा सकते हैं तो द डिफरेंस इज नेग्लिजिबल. एटलीस्ट कानों को तो कोई खास डिफरेंस नहीं है. इफ द इंटरफेस इज रियली वेरी वेरी एक्सपेंसिव, वेरी टॉप नॉच इंटरफेस विच हैज द हाईएस्ट क्वालिटी AD कन्वर्टर्स, यू माइट गेट स्लाइटली बेटर साउंड विद XLR दैन विद USB, बट दोज डिफरेंसेज आर माइनर. In all fairness, I would say that if you pay enough money for buying a microphone, not 2-3 thousand ka cheap USB XLR microphones that are available on Amazon. Good company Audio Technica or AKG or these companies, if you buy these microphones, their AD converters are pretty good, and there will be almost no difference between an XLR microphone and a USB microphone. USB microphone can only be better because XLR cables sometimes are nasty, you know, the cables kabhi kabhi short ho jati hai, they have troubles. Sometimes cables are, you know, कभी computer के पीछे से आ रही है, वहाँ पर वो कुछ interference पकड़ लेती है. तो उस लिहाज से in certain scenarios, if your cable is not up to the mark or cabling is not perfect, USB microphone can actually be a no hassle better option.
Right. Daksh is asking, so what is the difference between an audio interface and a mixer? And do you need both for a home studio?
No, you don't. You only need an audio interface. Audio interface, like I said, is a device which will convert your analog signal from the microphone, the electric signal from the microphone, into digital signal. Digital signal is 0-1 binary. So an audio interface ka wahi kaam hai. Analog ko digital mein convert karna. There are a few audio interfaces which also have a mixer built inside them, but otherwise aapko alag se mixer ki koi zarurat nahi hai. In studios also we do not have mixers. My studios do not have a mixer because it is not needed, it is redundant. All the mixing is done in the software. Why should you have an external mixer unless it is a live performance? If it is a live performance, absolutely, you will need a mixer. And when you're recording songs, you don't need a mixer these days because you can talk back ke andar hi, you can do all the routing and send. No, you don't need a mixer for home setup, definitely. And Sahil Baid is saying, no, you don't need both. Yeah, of course, if you have a USB microphone, you don't need either because the audio interface is inside the microphone. Yeah.
Right. And so let's talk a little bit about the difference in recording on different kinds of software for those who want to do their own recordings at home. What are the kind of softwares that you've tried out, how do you find the differences between all of these? I know everybody, for beginners, Audacity is considered the easiest and the best, but Audacity doesn't support video. So if you want to just talk about these, DAWs a little bit.
Right. So the elephant in the house is almost none of the DAWs which can import video can be available for free. There is only one that I know of. All others are paid. And it disheartens me to know that most of the people who have, you know, this solution of ghar pe Nuendo setup hai, and they also write it as their advertisement on WhatsApp groups, ke mere paas ye setup hai, Nuendo version ye hai. It is sad, but you are using a pirated version of Nuendo. I will never suggest you to do that. Please do not do so. I mean, at least even if you are doing, do not advertise it, because you know you are professionals and you're dealing with professional houses who deal with even more professional houses, international houses. You can't tell that, you know, I have a Nuendo setup at home. A Nuendo software costs somewhere around 85,000 rupees. Only 2 days ago, they are giving a 40% discount for this lockdown period, I think, and it has dropped to 50,000. But you know, Nuendo is a more expensive software than even Pro Tools. Pro Tools is in the ballpark figure of 40-45,000. Nuendo is 85,000. And wo wala software ek free version leke aap usko advertise mat karo ki main Nuendo pe record kar raha hu aur in sync record kar raha hu. At the most, I mean, please do not do that. There is a free software which is open source. If you want, you can subscribe to that software by paying certain money to them every month, which will be a gift to them, but it is free. I am planning to make a link or a video on how to import video, record a track on it and send to the client, which will be legal. It will be a professional quality thing, and at least you won't be crossing the legal line. That is about the sync softwares. About Audacity, it is free, it is open source. You can legally use it. You can legally not distribute it. You can distribute the software, download links to people. It is a good recording software. The recording quality is good. So go for Audacity. there are certain people who have broken this barrier of sync recording with Audacity. What they do is they import the audio from the pilot. If you import the audio from the pilot, right, you get a reference point on, you
you're
know,
pretty much matching.
Distance,
yes.
Pata chal ja, length pata chal jati hai. Aap saath mein ek dusre player mein video on karke rakh sakte ho. That is if your vendor is willing to give you the video. If the vendor is not giving you the video, then of course, you know, the earlier method is works equally fine, that you stream your video through Session Link Pro or Skype. Skype is also very secure. I use Skype to stream videos and you can record. Now, Anil ji ke saath, Anil Dutt, Anil ji ke saath, I have recorded with all the possible methods, you know, whether it is wild, whether it is wild with sync, which means I'll play back the video and he will just speak and it will get recorded in Audacity or on his phone, and with and things like Session Link Pro and Skype Video or Source Connect Now and Skype Video. I found that the one where I was just playing the video for him, I did not send him the video. मैं सिर्फ अपने यहाँ से वीडियो प्ले कर रहा था, द वीडियो वाज बीइंग स्ट्रीम्ड ऑन स्काइप एंड उनके वहां पर सिर्फ रिकॉर्ड हो रहा था, दैट्स इट, इट वाज गेटिंग रिकॉर्डेड, वो खांस रहे थे, बीच में रिपीट कर रहे थे, मुझसे बातें कर रहे थे, इट वाज ऑल गेटिंग रिकॉर्डेड, दैट्स ओके, क्योंकि हम वैसे भी रिकॉर्डिस्ट्स के पास अभी कितना टाइम है हाथ में, यू नो वी कैन ऑलवेज गिव आवर पीपल यू नो एडिट्स, चलो इसको सिंक में बिठाओ. सो आई फाउंड दैट मेथड टू बी द बेस्ट, where I'm just streaming the video from here with Skype and he's just recording there.
And he's recording.
Yeah, there is one issue. Kabhi kabhi blows ka pata nahi chalta hai. But then, you know, agar aisa pata chala ki pura lay down karne ke baad isme blow aage, we can always tell them ki ye wali line ek dobara leni hai. Aur jaise corrections hoti hai, you know, corrections to hoti hai. It can be taken during corrections time. Us lihaz se we can dub it. And agar pop filter wagera acha use kiya ho, to blows waise bhi kam aate hain.
Right, right. Have you tried out, which is the one you said, which is in sync, which we can record with in sync?
ARDOUR, Ardour. ARDOUR.
Okay.
It is an open source program. Okay. It is a professional program. Harrison Mixbus consoles, which was very widely used in Hollywood a decade ago, currently uses Ardour as its primary DAW for all its purposes. It can create music, it can record very well. I will create a short video on how to do it and I will share it on your Insta page so that people can know how to do it. I will try to keep it as simple as possible and I will not use any keyboard commands so that you know any layman can.
No shortcuts.
mouse driven.
Acha, ek baat batao Gaurang, have you checked out things like Adobe Audition or Adobe Pro or you know, SoundForge or GarageBand?
Adobe Audition I have checked out. Again, it is a paid software. It is a subscription-based software where in har mahine aapke account se paise jayenge. You can't buy it outright unless you want to pirate it, which I will not want you to do. Subscription model is available. I think it is somewhere on.
Bar bar bolna acha hai.
It hurts me because you know why. Software piracy is the same as film piracy or episode piracy.
Oh yes, of
course. When a Game of Thrones
leaks, any
piracy
is the same.
Or a Patal Lok leaks, it directly affects us.
All of us.
Yeah. Yes. So how can we let it happen when there are options? सिर्फ आपको थोड़ी मेहनत करनी है ना. आपको सीखने में थोड़ी मेहनत करनी है, लेकिन आपका कॉन्शियस क्लियर रहेगा, आप लीगली राइट साइड में रहेंगे, तो फिर क्यों करना ना?
Right.
Yeah, so Adobe Audition works well, definitely with the video. SoundForge cannot import video. SoundForge does not have that facility. SoundForge is like Audacity. What was the other one you said?
Right.
GarageBand. GarageBand, I've heard it works. I've heard GarageBand works, but I did not have it pre-installed
with
on
video.
My Mac. Yeah, with video. I've heard exporting the audio is a pain or something, someone was saying. But
it is
getting
a pain.
Getting GarageBand to start up hi nahi hua mere se. Matlab mere Mac pe main GarageBand install hi nahi kar pa raha hu. of course, because I'm still stuck at a previous operating system, because my Pro Tools cannot work on a newer operating system, and I'm not willing to pay for later versions of Pro Tools. I am happy with the one I have.
This whole problem with Pro Tools versions, Mac OS versions, and the hardware is just becoming a big nuisance now. It's getting more and more complicated every day.
Especially with Pro Tools, because they are, first of all, after Pro Tools 10, only Pro Tools 2020 is somewhat of a tolerable operation quality, but otherwise everything in between has been such a pain, especially with their cloud platform. Every time you make a session, you have to be sure that you're saving it to your hard drive, not to the cloud. Sign up required all the time. It's a pain right now.
It is a pain, and even with the latest version of Pro Tools, we are getting jitters in the video and we're just, constantly dealing with some problem or the other.
They stopped using QuickTime as their video background and started with Avid video engine, which is a painful engine to start with. So, yeah, but, hamare artists ke liye, it doesn't matter what Pro Tools is troubling them, because nobody is going to buy or invest in Pro Tools. Sahil has bought one license of Pro Tools.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes. No, actually, I'm hearing more and more of artists getting Pro Tools. But of course, they are getting them from their engineer friends, and they are all cracks. Sahil,
artists,
I know, has a licensed
me,
version. But
yeah, so many times artists have asked me, do you have a version? I deny, I don't have it. But I do have it. I don't use it.
Yeah.
Mostly. Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah. No, it's really sad. I mean, when you want to get the functionality of a proper software, you have to buy that software.
Yeah.
You can't expect to get a proper functionality without buying it. I mean, there will always be something lacking or something wrong with it. Yeah. I absolutely agree. So are you finding now more and more that voice actors are getting more and more used to home recordings, and they're getting better at it, and they're becoming more and more willing to spend time and money, invest time and money in their own home setups?
It has been difficult to convince artists to buy laptops who didn't have that. That was one.
Yeah. Why is that?
I don't know. They think that
they're afraid of not being able to use it. No, maybe
that
they're also afraid because they've never used one. Yeah.
Also, they are not able to ascertain the cost benefit of having a laptop. They are thinking, it is also because of us vendors for a time of initial lockdown periods, and even before that, in emergencies, we have okayed their Android phone qualities as well. So the blame also comes to us. Unhe lagta hai, why invest? Ho to raha hai kaam, but please invest. It will give you returns. There are ways to get it on EMIs also, but that beyond the point, it is going to be a good friend to you. But make sure you buy a good laptop. Don't buy those small ones which have a very slow hard drive and have just 2 GB RAM. Please don't buy those. Any laptop which is decent does not come for less than 30K or 35K. Buy something with a SSD.
And we've been home for 2 months, We've saved at least 50-60K on travel, right?
Yes.
So we might as well have that home setup.
So much on travel. Yeah, if you had the laptop
we've saved on travel.
If you had the laptop from the very first day, you could have actually earned the same amount of money in that amount of time. Yeah, it's just mathematics. They couldn't get around the mathematics. But even then.
So we've already saved the money to buy it. Okay, in the last 2 months of 3 months of lockdown, we've already saved the money. Secondly, from the day you buy it, you start earning money, and within the next 2 or 3 months, you recover the cost of the setup. Right?
And you get the regular laptop,
working artists.
And then you get to keep the laptop.
And Nishka is saying, I'm currently working on GarageBand. Is that good enough? I think quality-wise, it should be fine.
Quality-wise, right? It will not be any different. Oh, somebody has asked me about SM7B. My God, it's SM7B is the most expensive dynamic microphone. You don't need it, basically. You don't need it. If you have it, well and good, but you're not going to get a better quality than, say, SM58 for a home recording studio. If you have not bought it, please don't buy it. But if you have it, you're lucky. SM7B is the barb of all dynamic microphones.
How about Sony Vegas? Have you tried recording on that?
No, I have not recorded Sony Vegas. I have heard it works. But I have not recorded. Sahil Ved says he has SM7B.
Sony Vegas.
Yeah?
Huh? I've heard of RJs using Sony Vegas mostly.
No idea about Sony Vegas. I haven't used it. I used it long back, I say 20 years ago, but I have no experience with it. If it works, it works, but even that is not free. I mean, it's not free. You have to pay for it. See, the thing about why people are asking about Sony Vegas, Nuendo, things like these are PC softwares, and these have been around for quite a while. And PC softwares are so easily available in a pirated version. So, which is why, you know, we have these questions. That does this work? Does that work? Friend, stick to Audacity. Yeah. And I will prepare a small short video on Arduer, which is an open source free software. There will be no other software needed beyond this. I mix all my professional broadcast quality and even streaming quality programs on Arduer. It is that good. So even Audacity, so many things, there's a to and fro that I do between Audacity and Arduer. These are all, they give professional quality audio. Please do not go for these pirated stuff. You will have to learn them anyways, whether it is Sony Vegas or Pro Tools pirated or Nuendo pirated, you will have to learn them anyways. Aapko kisi na kisi recordist ka dimaag khana padega. I'll be very honest, मैं आज तक आर्डोर सबको सजेस्ट नहीं कर रहा था. मतलब मेरे जबान पे होता था कि जब कोई पूछता था ना कि आप कौन सा करें, तो मैं बोल देता था ऑलमोस्ट कि आर्डोर है, बट मैं बोलता नहीं था किसी को, बिकॉज देर आर नो इंजीनियर्स हु नो अबाउट आर्डोर. नोबडी नोज हाउ इट वर्क्स. तो सब कुछ मेरे सिर पे ही आएगा. अगर मैंने आर्टिस्ट को बोल दिया कि आर्डोर यूज करो, तो एवरी आर्टिस्ट के साथ रोज 2-3 घंटा सिर्फ उसको मतलब सिखाने में ही चला जाएगा. सो विच इज वाई आई वॉज अफ्रेड, बट नाउ आई हैव रियलाइज दैट देर इज अ वे आउट. Why not create a small video? Why not keep it simple and share it so everyone can use it? I will not have to spend my time as well.
But you're saying this because it's free or because it's easier to use than Nuendo and Pro Tools and whatever else, GarageBand?
GarageBand, they all have a learning curve. Nothing is easier. Audacity is easy, but you know, not much easier than not recording at all. If you compare Session Link Pro and Audacity, or Session Link Pro is the easiest. So there is a learning curve to all.
Not recording at all is the easiest.
Yeah.
I like that. Not recording at all is the easiest.
Yeah.
So someone is asking, for someone who stays in a place where you have a lot of traffic and a full window wall like yours, what are your suggestions on soundproofing and preferred mics?
Yeah, if you have a lot of traffic, you can't keep your window open, of course. But is there traffic on the road still?
There is. Yeah, I'm sitting in my office right now and I can hear, even though I have double glazed windows in my room, I can hear the traffic outside right now.
Right. I've always suggested that you should record at night. It's almost curfew these days. We have got to do with what we have. Yeah, record after the traffic is over. Don't record while the traffic is there. But because even if you think that you will keep the windows closed, poor traffic noise will be under aegi. If the traffic is that much, you will get the noise. Ideally, you should soundproof your booth, but it's not advisable because aap ghar ke andar ke kamre ko thodi soundproof kar sakte. Soundproofing means practically waterproofing it. Soundproofing, if you think of soundproofing, think of waterproofing. If you have waterproofed it, you have soundproofed it. You can't do that, you know. So stick to the night.
Yeah.
Stick to the night.
Okay. And okay, Suvigya is asking, is it normal to get static white noise even in the final edit?
What noise? White noise.
Is it normal static to white get noise. Static white noise even in the final? Yeah, even in the final edit.
Depends on your AD converter, which I told you the interface is, and depends on if you have recorded in a very low volume. If you have recorded in a very low volume, the noise is here, but the recording level is here. So if you jack everything up, the noise also increases. So you have to make sure that your gain is not less. It should be acceptable levels of minus 10 dB or minus 6 dB. It should not peak, but it can't be very low. If your gain is very low and then you send it for mixing, they will have to boost it up, then the noise will definitely increase. So, and that is what white noise can be. White noise can't be coming from bahar se unless you're in a very busy area jahan par all the more, you know, where the blabber is so much that it just gets converted, sounds like white noise. White noise will mostly come from your electronics.
Right.
Somebody's asking about question.
Is it Rode MPV? Oh my God, there's loads of questions here. Okay, is it preferred to record in a car?
Oh yes, very much. I forgot to tell about that. A car is very good for recording. It's very good for recording, but if you shout, the glass glass reflections will almost create some sort of a parallel distortion and will sound muddy or boomy. But you know, you aap jhuk sakte ho. Agar aapko koi chillane wala scene karna hai to back seat pe jaake aap jhuk ke kar sakte ho. But car is excellent because a lot of the car is foam and Dunlop and gadda. Car is very good for recording. I'm so sorry we skipped on this car thing last time. Car is very good.
Yeah.
Lekin jhuk jaiyega usko. Make sure.
Before when I had an interaction with Darpan, who travels a lot, so he had mentioned that he looks for cars wherever he goes. He looks for a taxi or
but make sure that the microphone is not
and
where the glass is
taking off on. Okay, Shure SM7B, does it make a big difference in the audio quality? No,
for home recording studio. The difference is very
no.
I can suggest
Rode
you
MP
one
mini.
I can suggest you one guy on YouTube. His channel's name is Podcastage, PodCastage. He tests every microphone ekdam dhyan se, matlab taali baja ke check karega, 2 inch door se, 4 inch door se check karega, alag alag microphone ko immediately change karke check karega. So, and he has tested almost all microphones. If you want to actually hear the audio difference between different microphones, go to his site and listen, and you will be surprised how much less difference of microphones makes to audio quality. The number one will be acoustics. Number one will always be acoustics.
Yeah.
That will make the maximum difference to your sound. Only then the microphone will come. Don't go for cheaper microphones. Good quality, good company microphones. वो जो हजार दो हजार वाले आते हैं वो नहीं. और there are exceptions. My ATR 1300, like I told you last time, is an exception. It gives me good quality sound and it is not very expensive. But go for good D5 from AKG is very good. But 7B पे खर्च करके कोई मतलब नहीं है.
Sandeep is asking, how is the Rode NT Mini?
Yeah, it's a dynamic microphone at the end of it. Condenser microphone at the end of it. So you will have all the issues with it as with condenser microphones. It will pick up more noise and reverb than a dynamic microphone. So for a home setup, it is recommended only if you think your acoustic is tight. One thing about Rode is I have tested Rode and other AKG and Rode's cardioid pattern, which means how much of the sound they capture, is tighter than other condenser microphones to my experience. I have seen people using Rode NT USB and Rode NT Mini USB. They have slightly less problems than people who use other AKG or other company condenser microphones. I'm not talking about the sound quality, I'm only talking about the noise and the reverb levels. It is slightly lesser, but nothing to beat dynamic microphones.
Yeah, I agree, because I tried an NT Mini at home and there was a lot of distortion.
Okay.
I don't know whether it's the natural gain of the mic that's very high or whatever. It's a lot of distortion. We had to keep on bringing down the gain to get a good recording.
Okay.
Hitesh is asking, what should be the basic settings while recording on Audacity?
The same 48 kilohertz, 24-bit, the same things now. How can settings be different? But just make sure that your gain is not loud enough, that it does not distort. Audacity is so simple and there is very little that can go wrong with it. So just matlab bedhadak hoke Audacity pe record kijiye. It will give a good sound. Make sure the gain is not too much, too less.
Vegan heart. Kya?
Make sure the gain is not too high or too low.
Okay. Vegan heart ice cream is asking
ATR 2100 is a condenser microphone, no? ATR 2100. Oh, it is a USB cardioid. Oh yes. It's a good microphone, but it's not available. Which is better, Samsung Q1 and ATR 2100? Both are equally good. I have used Samsung Q2, not Q1, and ATR2005, the earlier version of 2100. They both sound equally good. They are very good at eliminating reverb and noise. They sound professional. The audio quality is good. The high frequencies are not overly boosted. They're good microphones. You can get a good quality sound out of these both, Samsung Q1 and ATR2100, if they are available, but I know they are not available. Dub voice Raj.
Archana is asking, how's the Rode M1?
Guys, the thing is, there are so many microphones. I can't possibly know the quality of all. Like I told you, podcast stage is a good place to start. Rode M1 is a dynamic microphone and the cardioid pattern is good. So it is a good microphone. I can say it is as good as SM58 or Audio Technica or AKG D5. It's a good microphone if you have an interface. It is not a USB microphone. Also, someone is asking about Dub Voice Raj.
Have you tried an ATR 1300?
This is the ATR 1300. This is the ATR 1300.
Ah.
It's good. It's surprisingly good for 2500. Okay. Surprisingly good. But sir, ATR1300 Audio Technica doesn't require interface to amplify. It does require an interface. You can't use an ATR1300 or a Rode M1 or your SM58 without an interface. You will need interfaces. About the interface, you don't need to spend a whole lot in interface. You get something called as XLR to USB converters. I have some here.
Right. Oh, hi Rippy.
So this is the icicle. Okay, this is for how much? 4535. And this is the MXL XLR to USB. This is for 3999. So if you don't want to invest in an interface, you can go for these. Hi MP. So
yeah, right.
So I got big complaints from her last time. She said that I was shouting away for attention and you did not give me any bow. So yeah, here's all your bow. All right.
That's Anindita Bose who has joined us.
Yeah. All right. So how
what about audio? M-Audio dynamic cardioid mics? What about good, M-Audio good, 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 dynamic good. Cardioid mics?
All dynamic cardioid mics are really good. All dynamic cardioid microphones are really good, but if you can get hold of unidirectional microphones, they are even better for home recording. Unidirectionals are the best.
But Raghav is saying, I have a unidirectional mic JTS TK350, and it doesn't pick up any external noise or echo, but I get a hissing noise. Is it because it's a cheap sound card I'm using? Can I use Focusrite solo interface?
Now, first of all, let me hunt for this microphone. I haven't heard about this company. What is this TK350?
My online research.
Yeah, क्या करूं? Because I am getting questions like this, na. I haven't heard about this company. Maybe.
JTS PK 350.
Yeah, I have it. I mean, Flipkart पे available है for 2,500. I don't. Maybe it is a good quality microphone, and it is possible that it is the sound card which is a problem. Focusrite, of course, is an excellent sound card. The noise levels will be very low, but I have doubts on this microphone itself in the first place.
Okay.
It says it is unidirectional. No, Samsung Meteor is not, because it is a, first of all, a condenser microphone, and it is not, the cardioid pattern is not very tight. It will catch some reverb and noise as well.
Okay.
Also about Zoom, some people have been using Zoom microphone. Now, I have had issues with Zoom actually. You see, Zoom is a very, very sensitive microphone, and the name suggests that it is supposed to capture frequencies from afar. It is a field microphone, जहाँ पर आप दूर से भी कोई आवाज record कर सकते हो. So अगर आप उसको पास ले जाके चिल्लाते हो ना, तो सारा distort करता है. Also, I found that the lip noises were exaggerated in a Zoom microphone recording. इतनी lip sounds आ रही थी.
Right, because it's not intended for close.
No, even when the artist is using a pop filter, the lip sounds were enormous. I asked him, "Are you having a bad day? Do you have a cold?" He said, "No, कुछ ऐसा तो नहीं है." मतलब एक के बाद एक recordings. He sent me 5 recordings on 5 different occasions. हर एक में lip sounds ज़्यादा है. So it is because first of all, its gain for high frequencies is really high. It is a very sensitive microphone for long distance. So maybe that is the reason, but right. I found Zoom quality to be, also the noise of the surrounding noise was much louder than other dynamic microphones. So Zoom, I don't really recommend much.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Raj is saying, "Ghazab gyan hai aapka, Gaurang sahab."
I don't know. It's...
Thank you, Gaurang. Thank you so much
for
sharing so much knowledge with us and coming, spending 2 hours with us last week, this week, to answer all these questions. It's very important for people to be able to clarify their doubts. Not everybody has a go-to person, but I would also strongly recommend to everybody to get in touch with a sound engineer friend and do a little bit of testing.
Yeah.
So that they can also help you with the audio quality and give you some feedback on how you've managed to build your home setup. But I have a question, personal question for you, Gaurang. So, you know, in my office, I have double glazed glass. And if I were to build, I'm just thinking potentially, if I were to build like one room with some amount of double glazed windows and... you know, without too much of soundproofing, just heavy curtains, double glazed windows, things like that. You think I can manage a little, some kind of acoustically treated room?
Yes, why not? If your double glazed windows have a curtain, if you can have very thick curtains, and you can keep them open when you want the view, and whenever you're recording, you can close them, and make sure that you have bass traps installed, and bass traps made of rock wool or glass wool, not of foam. If you have bass traps installed and those walls which the microphone will be hitting directly can be covered with acoustic panels, say rock wool panels or glass wool panels, then it should work well. It should work well. Why not?
Okay, great.
But bass traps is very important.
Thank you so much. Bass traps, na?
Yeah.
Well, I'm learning. I'm also learning slowly and surely after, God knows, 40 years of having been around and being totally spoiled. Walking into a room, everybody tells you, aise khade raho, yahan pe face karo, upar dekho, niche dekho, ye padho, ye bolo, aise bolo, waise bolo, yahan bolo, wahan bolo. You know, you're told everything. We are so badly spoiled that now, after all these years, when somebody tells me ghar pe record karo, I'm like, nahi, I think retirement ka time aa gaya.
Really?
So
I'm feeling like नहीं यार मैं गोरांग के घर चली जाती हूँ या किसी के घर चली जाती हूँ
most welcome
I'm trying to find the engineer closest to me and or maybe I'll just try to learn GarageBand and figure it out or Ardour as you're saying.
Ardour is better than GarageBand. Yeah. I will drop that link very soon.
Is Pro Tools better than Ardour?
I find Ardour better.
Really?
Yeah.
We've also rediscovered about Fairlight and that's
Fairlight.
Become free now so yeah
okay let me visit Fairlight yes let me visit Fairlight and if I find
only,
that it is
only free. Our generation knows about only our generation knows about Fairlight nobody else but it was one of its kind it was like the god of sound recording software at one time.
Someone is asking a very
Nishka, you're going to teach me how to use GarageBand. I hope Nishka is going to teach me how to use GarageBand. So Nishka, next
first of all, you should
studio,
get
please teach me how to use yeah, GarageBand.
First of all, you should get it installed. It doesn't install. I mean, it doesn't run. I mean, it was a Mojave system. I
mera chal raha hai.
Achha, not a technical question, but do voice artists regret getting spoiled by the movies they dub for, like for extremely secretive movies like Avengers? This is for you, Suvigya Bas.
By spoiled, matlab kya? Of course, we are spoiled. We are very spoiled. But how do you mean spoiled? Yeah, because you know we are directed by fantastic directors. We are directed by fantastic directors. See, actually, you know what? You can call it being spoiled. You can call it being taught. I think everything I have learned has come from my mother, watching her friends, watching her peers, just sitting in the room and watching people record. Because, you know, back in the day, there used to be massive recording rooms and we used to be sitting on the floor in the carpet. I used to be sitting and doing my homework while other people were recording. So, you know, sun sun ke, I think in my sleep also, I can tell somebody ke ye sahi lag raha hai sunne mein, ye galat lag raha hai sunne mein. So you learn a hell of a lot.
Yeah.
You learn so much from the sound engineers you work with. All the technicalities we know today, we've learned from the sound engineers we have worked with. You know, ek se ek sound engineers we have worked with. The directors I have worked with, you know, they each one pushes you to your limit. They right. push you to do something you can't do. And that is right. what you have to appreciate, that they're asking you to do something different. They're right. asking you to push your limits. And
right.
how else will you do anything new or anything different Correct. Or anything challenging?
Correct.
I mean, I would be brain dead if I were doing the same thing day after day after day
right.
and not
right.
being challenged. So there's nothing like being spoiled. I don't think you can get spoiled. Yeah, hi Swati. Swati's here. She's saying, I can't retire. Oh, Swati. Desserts. I retire, you teach me how to make desserts, and that is our new business model.
Wow.
So anyway, Gaurang, we're running out of time. Thank you
yes.
so much. This has been super. Lovely two sessions. Anybody want any more topics from Gaurang, please let us know. I'd be more than happy to get him back.
One more. No, I think most of things are answered. Most of the things are answered.
Yeah, okay. So see you all soon. See you next weekend with another great guest. And thank you once again, Gaurang. And we look forward to having you back.
Thank
goodbye,
you.
Goodbye, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us.
Goodbye,
thank you
goodbye,
for,
goodbye.
All your
you will have to end it.
And thanks again. Yes, I will. If I can figure the end button. There it is. Bye.
Bye-bye.